because it's quite expensive. I think it's about 10,000 naira per day. A is 5,000 naira, B is 4,000, so 10,000 naira per day. That is quite expensive. By the time the man finish the boat, he probably go and sell one of the other land to pay the debt. But what we now do is we create what we call flotation tanks. In our boats, we have flotation tanks every year compared with the capacity. What is boat building itself? Boat building begin from SOR, statement of requirements. What exactly am I doing with my boat? Now, what is the weight involved? I'm doing this thing from here. What is the weight involved? That's what actually gave me a result of what is my number of my flotation tank. Now if I have the impact, then the hull itself is divided by 4 or 5. Now if I have impact, let me use this as a case study. This is a hollow pipe. Inside here, water can get in. What brings the boat down is when water gets in, the weight of the water is higher than the weight of the hull. Now, what we now do this day is we divide this hull this way. First, we now divide it like 3 or 4. Now, if they have impact, because the truth of the matter here is that I'm not saying our government is going to have a petition, but the truth is they will not be able to take off all the wreck on our waterways so soon. Sorry, excuse me. We will not be able to take the wreck off our waterway so soon.
For all the same waterway we have in America and the rest, the wreck will be there. Probably some, we are even adding some now. The treasure boys are there doing their thing. After they
finish their thing,
they left some of the pipe. And some of their irons are just sunk in the process of working. They go up, no one is talking about it. For that reason,
that wreck is going to be there for the next, I don't know. Now, what we need to do is to go a little bit higher. Engineering is like, let me use engineering as a case study. Everything in engineering is risky. But what we do, we manage the situation and go a bit higher than the risk. So I think that's what we should do on the waterway now. That is where aluminum comes in.
If you give me your
3 mm and I give you my 2 mm, I am still stronger than you.
I feel far better than you.
Cost
duplication.
Yes, it's expensive. And everything in aluminium is custom built. I can go anywhere. I can go to length, any length. I can do anything professionally. Cost duplication. It's not necessary. If I put a needle on this paper, it's probably going to bend it. Look at what I did. It's plain, right? It's plain. Now, what we do today is we mitigate condition to create more strength and reduce more material for cost inflation. We create more condition. Instead of using our material more of that, we collide them.
We fold in different shapes. Now, this is plain. It cannot carry any load, right? But when I do this,
becomes heavier. But in case of aluminium, no. I don't know if you have seen your meter, any meter you drop in water that has that soaked water before. I don't know. Have you got any? Thank you. That's the life of aluminium. Now I will talk a bit about corrosion. We paint our boat because our customer want us to give them a certain color. We don't really need to paint. We don't. We do not need to paint it. So if you ask me, I will say the boat, 21st century boat, is aluminium. My professor speak a lot about grade and numbers, but the 21st century boat to go with is aluminium. If you have to do anything at all, it doesn't mean fiber is bad. No, fiber is good, but everybody has their environment really wants to buy it. And if you ask me how many boats can you build for me in 2-3 months, well, it's a very good question. But the truth of the matter is, you know, this industry is just we are just coming up. I can't build what Chinese will build in 2 months. Chinese can build 200 boats in 2 months. Fine. But if you give me the same boat and I plug my CNC machine to cut my grades, if you give me 10 boats, I can run it for you in 2-3 months. The only thing I need is the boat should be the same thing. All I do is I cut my first template and I run everything. And in 2-3 months we have the boat. Capacity is being built and we are trying to grow. Don't also forget that it's a technology that is being transferred. We don't have everything here. We still depend on people like Yamaha that will bring engine from 10,000, 12,000 kilometers away. So it's not being assembled here. We are not building, we are not fabricating the engine here. So those whole things will be taken into consideration. I imported ordinary fender, side fender of boat. And 5 days later, this thing come all the way from Dubai to Lagos Airport. But you know something? It took me 2 months to be able to clear that fender. I mean, polyfoam fender, ordinary side fender, sausage fender, it's popularly known as sausage fender. So this whole thing is a job. So when you say Chinese can build 10 in 1 day, yeah, they have everything available to them. But here we don't. We depend on importation. And our customs don't want to get anything marine. They really are strict. Ladies and gentlemen, on this note, I will